Okay. Welcome back. Last time, you may have gotten to see me fumble my way through the first two puzzles of the Wizard Tower. You may not have, because you may have given up in disgust at the sheer amount of time it took me to solve those puzzles. But here we are. We're in the library. And we'll see if I can do better. So this, I'm pretty sure, procedurally generated, but it lets us get at more parts of the game. So, obviously, we picked up the state machine generator last time. Let's not make that spacebar, though. Let's make it 2. So, state machine, let's just get at something that I guess is much harder for the game to show directly as an object that we can then access. So we can see, primary host state, blah blah blah. This generates a whole lot of things. I guess this kind of generates us? Yeah. So we can do a variety of things. One thing I did realize, and I spent a bit of time trying to get fixed, because I think it's a bug, is I'm not sure if it's in this particular file. There's a type called load bool, which if I try and edit, it causes a crash, and we had that last episode a lot. So hopefully I can solve the game without needing to modify a load bool, because yeah, otherwise kind of boned, can't really get anywhere. So I'm not sure what to do with this right now. I'm sure it'll come in handy later on. I think what we want to do right now is see if we can have a look at some of the keep rooms. Yeah. Dweeb keep. Let's see what is in here. Layouts, entities, rooms. So, armory, dungeon, lobby, secret tunnel. This is our set of rooms for the dungeon that we're in. Let's ignore that for the moment. I don't really care about the dungeon. What we would like to do is fix this tower that we're in, such that there isn't a trap that ruins everything. Let's try Dower Tower. Entity layouts, rooms. So, DRM, roof, magic gate, library of Babel, lure. That seems like a good one to take. Tower level 2, staircase 3. Princess chambers, copy. These, I'm sure, are totally irrelevant. World tree, level 5. I think we got stuck in level 2. Let's take and let's have a look at world 2. On it, don't crash. On alarm, on alarm off. On crash timer. 7 segment clock, clock entity, clock ticking equals false. On alarm. Alarm. Okay. So, we here could change the alarm time. Let's dive in. So, timer, I'm pretty sure that the time we want is this 0.5, maybe? I don't know, thought it was a bit longer than that, but I This game does a number on my CPU, as it turns out. All these rooms. Don't know if it actually does a number on the CPU. It just takes a long time. So I could change this up a bit. Well, let's change it up to this. Who knows? Maybe that'll help. Maybe that won't. Okay, so timer, new timer. Tick is basically run the timer. On entrance trigger, we have our little play. Crash, keep out, error. So, we could do very little. Or, we could find out what happens. Don't crash. Yeah, so that plays something. Library exit sets our exit to the Library of Babel, which is the library that we're in. So, we could turn off the entrance trigger. We could try and set it such that it doesn't crash. Ah, crash seconds. Crash. So, uncrash timer. What I want to do mostly is change it so that at the end, when it calls crash, why don't we just set it to call not crash or don't crash? See, self dot. Self crash. If we change that to don't crash, what do we get? Okay, you can change. I'm pretty sure it is don't crash this kind of capitalization because capitalization is important. So let's call a different function. Function of not crashing. Okay. So, if I've got this right, we should be able to get out. And do this. The other thing would be to play around with the layouts, and I might do that in a bit. Who knows? Okay. Hey look, a clock. Okay. Yeah. It doesn't crash. That's great. Downside is it doesn't not crash. In that it doesn't open the doors for us, does it? But at least it doesn't cause the game to die. It doesn't cause the game to die. So Dower Tower. Alright, let's have a look at layouts. DRM roof. This sounds pretty interesting. Anyway, level 2. Layout. Let's take it and see what we got. I guess the point is that eventually you may just want to put some of this back. I don't know why, though. I like carrying around a stupid number of things. Ah. So, there's not actually much you can do with layouts. From what I can tell. Unless there is something that I can do with it, I don't really see the point. Alright. I guess this calls for more monkeying with the room's lure code instead. See, that's the thing. Like, I thought it should play this. Don't crash. Crash. Yeah, that number is... I don't know what that number does, but it doesn't do what I want it to do. Yeah, like cars don't crash. So, actually, there's a few things we could do. We could change the exit to the library, to the staircase 2 exit. Which would allow us to bypass this problem. We can't just make it inactive because it uses load bool, which causes us problems. I'm kind of tempted to change the exit, but what I might do, if I'm gonna do that, is write down the original. I mostly would just like to turn off the trigger. Is that visible, etc., etc.? 17 o'clock. What if I can change something else? On entrance trigger, yeah, define logic trigger, get collision area, open doors. On crash timer, no. Start timer. Cool. Crash seconds. Where does it even get crash seconds from? I have to say, working with the bytecode is kind of painful. Crash hours is... yeah. Okay, so this just... calls the timer. So I guess you call the timer with... time value, crash hours, set time, crash hours minus one, yeah, tick is the timer, on entrance trigger, we play this, crashes, don't crash is what we have it set to. Where is the timing number set? Because I've tried to monkey with that before. What if I just actually alarm off, open doors? Oh, the portal is set based on where you have the code selected. That is something I should have really noticed before, but that is really cool. And I need to remember that I don't need to go back into the library. Now I'm carrying this book around. What's entities? I haven't actually looked in here. Wow. Ah, this is the clock and the wizard bat and wizard head. Magic gate, etc. Wizard. Alright, let's not bother with that right now. We can always come back to the library. I hope. I suspect when we get to the roof, I'm gonna need to do things based on things in here. But right now, let's get back out to level 2 and see what we can do. Maybe. I'm just gonna go out on a limb here. Maybe I shouldn't be moving quite so quick. 1,000 move speed is really more move speed than I would like. Okay. 2, 1. Opened. Oh, right, yes. There's this. Yeah. Nope. Come on, I told you to open the doors. Rude. Oh, I know what that is. Yeah, okay. So, remember when I said this to 14.5? I'm pretty sure that is the gap between the clock flashes. Let's change that back to 0.5. Won't make any sense, it's a negative number. Oh, right, yep. Yeah. Okay, alarm's off and the doors are open. Excellent, that's all we really care about. Although I suspect that if I had let it play Don't Crash, that would have been more interesting. Oh, come on! How could you possibly have known to turn off the death clock? The traps just aren't that good. It's true. You're cheating! I'll stop you! Kind of picture Christo as a petulant, like, 17-year-old. Ah. Yes. So, that thing about moving too quickly. It's true. Although, why did that hit me there? Anyway, let's drop our move speed to something a little bit more manageable. Oh god. It's sticky. Why would you do this? Okay. Also, don't need to go down there at this time. Oh wow, this looks scary. I'm not even doing anything. Yeah. And this is an entrance to the library. But yeah, I'm pretty sure the library is going to be necessary to handle most of these. This trap really isn't going to do anything? Did the wizard even finish this one? Probably. Got past the cannon? I don't think it was working. What? That's one of my most nefarious traps. It wasn't doing anything. It was working when I built it. You broke it. Why do you ruin everything? That's pretty cute. As I said, yep, petulant 17-year-old, it just feels like that is the right thing. I don't think anything's coming. They just need to fix some platforms? We've done that before. He seems too restrained for the wizard. I wonder if he actually did something clever with this trap. And when even Bob doubts it... Well, I mean, right now, there's no panel, so it's just... Yeah. So I need to get back to the library. Yeah. I kind of wonder what would happen if you fixed the cannon, but I'm not going to, because that seems counterproductive. Okay, so. Whoops. Actually, let's put back room. Wait, that's not what I want. Let's put back the room code I had before, which is the staircase 2. I appear to have an extra copy of tower. Oh wait, staircase, not tower level. There's where tower level 2 goes. Yep, let's put it back for now. Now, tower level 3. No, tower level 4. Where it's at. Yeah, let's take that. I'm fine. While we're at it. And world tree. Let's just, yeah, take the things that we're pretty sure we will need. So I guess that also means the library roof, the JRM roof, and the magic gate. I doubt we'll use all of them this episode as a warning, but let's see how we go. Oh, tile level 4 is what we've got as number 2 already. Excellent. I'm very surprising how easily it is to accidentally enter a level of the library. Also, interesting thing about the library in the save file, it does not appear. And let's just see how far back we go. Yeah. See, this is me mucking about last night trying to get that field GUI stuff working. Or rather, it not crashing every time I try and change load bool. Oh yeah, actually, while I think about it, there's a couple of interesting things that were meant that I ran across, right? I'm definitely not going to say that I came across this. Key thing about Isis is she's not really searching the universe. She's looking for global values and information about you, so... So, let's go with wishes. Alright, so, let's do this. I have 2 wishes left. What I like to change that back to... Let's go with... a high number. Stars now speak of 999. So, if we get him up... Yeah, look, we have unlimited wishes. That's not cool. That's not what I wanted to do. Alright, so let's first increase our wishes to all of them. Then let's go back here. Much like I could change my name, I can change my max health. And it should, there we go. My health is now the appropriate number for this theme. Okay, let's have a look at the code for you. Alright, nothing to see here. Choose Tile to Destroy, Tiles to Destroy. If verify choices, okay. So. Verify choices if that go there, otherwise don't. So basically, what I'm seeing here is, let's change this. I know it's got a USB port. It's not. Okay. There. This seems like it should totally fix it. Unless it's a filthy trap. So, the tiles are destroyed when I enter the room. Ha-ha! So, maybe. Oh wow. Let's go back to the staircase. Maybe. Nothing to see here isn't a way of fixing that. Okay, so I guess there's something about the Tiles to Destroy algorithm that can have it choose the valid tiles. Okay, so it destroys is even. There you go. One to eight. If it's even, do this. If it's not, do that. So on an even number, destroy tile. Or don't destroy tile. Yeah. Is even I. So, what happens if we change this to 2, and then increment... Oh wow, so I can't change the increment value. Increment by 2, right, so it is incrementing by the same amount. Okay, so now, it'll always be an even number. Okay. Let's go back to before we edited that back. Yeah. Okay. So we know that's working. Now let's make our choose tiles to destroy thing. Yes, let's dive in here. So, we've only got even tiles. And we've got a smaller number of tiles. Okay, that is indeed what broke it. I really love that branching. That branching is great. Okay. Now. Alright. Change it. Okay, so. Apparently. Whoops. Just deselected the window, that was awkward. So let's go with this. I can't change that. Okay, so we've got a max value, we've got a minimum value. So change this to 4. This to 3. So that should mean we are looking at, it tests a single tile, that tile is an odd number, and it does that. Nope. Some attempt to call global error, nil value. Okay. I'm not approaching this the right way. Tile error. Stop. Ah, error. stop meddling with the code from 1 to 8. Yeah. Yes. Tile names that destroy. So if this goes into here, error. Yeah. All right. So what happens if I do this and go? Now let's make our change. Because monkeying with things is what we're here to do. Okay. Okay. Let's make a slight change here. On two styles to destroy. Although tile error is, yeah, from 1 to 8. Now, let's change this. So, whatever we've done, yeah, it does not like this. Okay, so. Let's see what happens if I change that to a print statement. I'm likely to need to go back in time. Yeah. I love that. Okay. So I reckon that this is ruining everything. It loops through everything, self.tile names, and it destroys everything. Because it's jerk. So, where does that even get called? Verify choices, that I'm pretty sure is the verify choices thing. Yeah. Yes. Alright, so this matches. Does that fix anything? I mean, woohoo, I changed the exact opposite. Fantastic, cause yeah. Okay. Whoops. This. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So we give him a negative number. Which, well, we give it a range that it shouldn't loop through at all. There we go. Easy. And again, we've got an entrance to the library and the stairs. And let's see what our wizard has to say. Something me sometime. How am I supposed to? I don't have time to argue. Hold them as long as you can. Okay, Christo. Just go. The problem is, alright, time for a good talk. Is this thing already on? You two listening in? Ah! It's nice to be acknowledged.
Come no further!
Ronigo, do we have to fight a sprite? Who are you? I'm the wizard's friend. I'm here to stop you. How are you going to do that? I'm going to ask you politely. Why isn't the wizard here? He has more important things to do than playing games with you. Yeah, that really doesn't sound like him. Look, we don't want to fight. We're going up there to stop him. You must stop. He's just keeping the kingdom safe. Oh, the thing. Hasn't he kidnapped the princess or something? That made sense at the time. Uh-huh. This seems suspicious, and pretty obvious that only Christo could be trusted with such power. Why is this? Yes. He made me. He made all the red sprites, Bob.
Really?
Huh. I see. Let's see. I wonder if I can change her mind. Nope. Alright, what happens if I go past? Yeah, Eve, Christo. So, it has come to this. Hey! I suppose I was right all along. You've caused enormous amounts of damage. Consulted with criminals, broken out of prison, detonated explosives in a government building, and been a horrid jerk. This is one thing you're better than us. Only I can be trusted with any kind of power. There's really only one thing to do. Fireballs, whoosh! Oh! Interesting. Uh-huh. Well, I feel this is a good stopping point. Mostly because, yeah, big fight. So, I'm gonna stop here.